Today is April 9, 2020. Hello, Maria-Paula Avila. Welcome on VH Berries.
Hello, Victor.
So, is it true that you are at the same distance of the North Pole as you are from the South Pole?
We are in the middle. I'm in Ecuador.
So yes, you are from Ecuador. Can you introduce yourself?
Yeah, sure. I'm from Ecuador. I have 19 years old. I'm in my last year of school. So, and it's a good year, but right now we are living a big case and situation. I have one younger sister. And I live with all my family.
So, Quito is the capital of Ecuador. Where are you exactly in the country?
Yeah, I'm in Pichincha. That is the province. Inside there is a part that it's called Cumbaya, and I live in Cumbaya.
Oh, great. Have you always been there in your lifetime?
No, I have lived also in Quito, like there.
At the center.
Also in the center and in Cumbaya and MBC, we have moved a lot because when I was little, I went to live in Spain, in Madrid, 1 year. And then we came back and went to live with my grandparents in Quito.
So yeah, so in Ecuador, you speak Spanish. So according to you, what makes Ecuador, so your country, so special?
Well, I think Ecuador is a very special country because, first of all, it's a very touristic country. You have a lot of places to visit. Like when you come here, they tell you to go like to Mindo or Tubaños, or Otavalo is one of our most visited places because there we have this, the clothes they make there are very comfortable. Also, we have our special food that it's called ceviche. Ceviche is with marine stuff and with a little like juice. I don't know how to tell it. It's from tomato. When you make it with shrimp, also we have fritada that it is like meat with. With mote. So it's our traditional plates. Also, the people here are very helpful. They care for other ones. And especially you can see a lot of things like you can see that Ecuadorians are very proud about their nationality.
And in general, I guess that this is maybe a spicy food. Do you agree?
No. No, there's not so many spicy food. Here is like more like pork and that stuff. Like, but also, like, we have a lot of stuff. Also, our holidays, we celebrate New Year's Eve, Christmas, Carnival, and Easter. Like, and also the Day of the Dead, the Independence Day is one of the most important. Yeah, because we independated from Spain. When we independated from Spain, we celebrate here in Ecuador.
So, Maria, you are 18 years old?
19
years old, okay. So, you are at your last year of high school, and the Ecuadorian government said that you are not going back to school.
Yeah, that's true. So, right now, I'm literally... having my last year of school at home, so I think I'm losing a lot of experience in my last year, like everything with my classmates, with the teachers and everything of that. Like right now I can see that I miss a lot of school because I know that I thought that my last year was going to be a great year, a very funny year, a lot of parties, having fun with my classmates, but now we are at home. Having online school and everything.
So in the news, we can see that there is very serious case of the COVID-19 and all this virus in Ecuador. So How are you and your family dealing with this situation?
Well, we are always, we are protecting, we are cleaning everything. Also, when someone is going to go out, we make sure that she or he takes a hand sanitizer, alcohol, and a face mask. So we are protected and we have a less chance to get contagious.
And so, for example, in the last few weeks, how many times did you get outside to buy grocery, for example?
My mom is the one that goes to buy the groceries, or my dad, because we can only go out one person per family or in the car. So my mom goes to buy groceries like passing 3 weeks, so we make it. So we are always trying new things and everything of that. If I go out, it will be just here to the mini market that it's 2 minutes ago from my home.
So Maria-Paula, we are maybe too soon to judge, but what did all these events with this virus had told you? What did you learn from this?
Well, what I have learned with this, with thing of the virus, is that we aren't so conscious about our cleaning. So right now I have realized that we don't have most of the things clean, like our desks are not clean at all. So this time I have cleaned it, like I've saw that how many dirt there is, or we are not so conscious that what we eat we don't clean it or wash it in the correct form. So there will always be something that can make us sick. So now we are, when my mom buys groceries, she sanitized them and sure. Then washed them.
So are for security. Now are you scared to shake hands?
No, like I know that most of the people are taking the same recommendations and is always trying to get clean, so because no one wants to get contagious about this virus.
Sure. So now, Maria-Paula, let's move to another subject that you are very attached to. It's a project and an organization called Operation Smile. What is it exactly?
Well, this is an organization that was founded in 1982. What this organization is in charge is to provide operation and service to people that have cleft lip and cleft palate. This works all around the world. So there are a lot of departments in different states. This also works with kids, especially because they help kids. So after the operation, they give them also some information how to treat them right and everything, because the first objective from Operation Smile is to give us a big smile to the people. So right now we are helping them, and this fund is very, very creative because there are 3 missions per year in different countries.
And the motto of the organization is "It all starts with a smile."
Yeah, but in here we have different clubs, so changing. So that's the original one, the original logo. But we created our own in the different clubs, like one smile for a world. One smile can change someone's world.
Yes, that's great. So this organization operates in 34 countries all around the world. And when did it start for you at the school club?
Well, at my school club, it started I think it was 2 years ago in my school, or 1 year ago. But I started to, I could enter to the club this year. This year I started in this club. So we have done a lot of stuff to help them in my way of thinking. And like, we have a commit. Like, he's like the president, vice president, and all the important people. So right now I'm there, but I have to see which one will be the next one, because like, this is my last year, so I have to give my place to the next one.
Sure. So, Maria-Paula, you also told me that you went 1 week in Colombia to make some activities and speaks.
Yeah, okay. I went to Colombia 1 week to a thing called LEA, that is Latin American Acción. So, there are the different clubs. So, this time was in Colombia, and there are people from all the countries that have that work with this organization. So in this place, we had different talks and everything about some mentors and people that have, maybe they tell us their stories and everything and that, and then we know about them and we know how they have dealt about with that. Also, we had activities that we can have fun and everything, and we can tell that, yeah, Operation Smile is a very, very cool fund. They also have missions, volunteers, and this, like, trips, if we can say. So we know people from other parts, and we know how the other organizations work. So now if we don't have like an idea of what to do to recollect, I have talked with some friends and they'll help. Yeah, you can do this and this, yeah. Maybe. And so we have put it in practice here in my my school club. And we have recollected a lot of stuff. Like, we had to recollect money so we can help them. And, so we decided to sell ice creams in my school. So we talked with the director, and she told us, yeah, it would be a very good idea. So every time we sell ice creams there, we recollect a lot of money, and then we send the money to the organization here in Ecuador.
Yes, because that's amazing, because kids with a cleft lip, they may face bullying and social isolation, and Operation Smile helped them to include in the society.
Yeah, that's true. There have been cases that they have told us they have suffered bullying, but that's why the operations happen when they are little. And they haven't started school, but this organization also operates to adults. So they help the people that can't pay a surgery. They help them by operating them. I would like to tell you one of my experiences in one of the missions I went here in Ecuador.
Sure.
Okay, so we had this mission here in Ecuador in one of the hospitals. We were from 7 a.m. till 7 p.m. We got there, we started decorating the hospital. It was a very cool experience because you saw everything, like you couldn't realize that. So when we started, they gave us a talk, our teachers. So we always have to be happy, have a smile. We played with the kids because, sure. And we have to tell them like, okay, everything is going to be fine. I'll be here when you get out. So sometimes we go with them downstairs and then play with them in a room. And then after that, we take, especially one of my favorite parts was when I had to take one kid after the surgery to his mom. It was so, well, like he take she like the mother take the baby and they know, and after the surgery,
oh,
they see the kid operated and everything. So one of the mom was like, where is my kid? It has been like a lot of time. And I was like, yeah, everything's going to be fine. And then I came down and they gave me one, a baby, and wow. I came back and he told me like, oh, he, and it was her baby. So I almost started crying because it was so, oh my, it was so beautiful. Like your mom was my baby. He's back again. I love him. And I was, she was thanking me a lot. It was so, my skin was so, like when you get chicken skin. Have you ever seen that? It was a beautiful moment because the mom was, I was very worried. Like you can see the moms and you tell them like, yeah, go, I'll be very attentive and everything. So go have something to eat, because there are people that are there since 5 a.m. till, I don't know. So when you see the mom with the baby, they're like, oh my God, he is so beautiful. It's a very, very beautiful experience. The kids, especially the ones that are younger, they are so like, you can sit with them and tell them like, okay, tell me about your stories. Tell me about everything. And they start to tell you everything. And you laugh, everything. So when it's time to go or everything, they're telling, no, please don't go. So that's why when you go, it's like, oh my God, it was a very, very beautiful experience. If I can continue to do it, after finishing school, I'll love it because I love Operation Smile.
And do you use some music and do you dance with them, for example?
Oh, yeah. In that time we went, like, I went with two friends and they were like 13 maybe. And so, first of all, the organization weren't so, didn't agree that they go because it's a very hard stuff. But they were, no, they said, no, we want to go. We love a precious smile. We want to play with the kids. So the organization saw them and they told, okay, they can go. But if you go with a teacher and with someone that will not get scared. So I was like, okay, I'll go with them. So one of the kids was, okay, we're going to close the door of the room and we're going to put music. So I entered and they were like, she was acting and they were dancing, having fun. Like my friend acted them like, okay, I'm going to act in my life. So it was so funny. Like you can see the kids laugh a lot and everything. So, and also they like to color. They are very, they love coloring and everything.
And I think that this small moment, this kid will always remember them for the rest of their life.
Yeah. Yes, like they told us, like, I would love, some of the kids told us, I would love to see you again or everything like that, because, and you're like, oh my God, I think this is so beautiful that you can't stop smiling, even though if you want to, you can't. What look like, the one I told you I have to take the baby, like, one nurse told me, like, he won't stop crying. So I don't know why, but I had the, I made this unconsciously, so I grabbed him and put my cheek in his head and started singing him, and he fell asleep, and the doctor was like, oh my God, you have a very good hand with kids. I hope you stay working here in Operation Smile.
And what is this chicken about?
No, it's like a chicken skin is when like your skin goes like, when you have goosebumps, have you ever
had
it? Oh,
yes, okay, so yeah. It's a metaphor, so, it's not really yeah. A chicken hat that you put on them, that's great to know, okay.
No, it's just a metaphor, like, okay. It's like goosebumps, but from happiness, when you are so happy about something that your hair goes, like, up in your arms.
Oh, yes, okay.
If you want to know something else about Operation Smile, you can search about them in their Instagram, in Facebook, or in the internet. They are a very, very cool information organization. And also you can see, if you see the pictures, you can see how everyone is happy about doing this. No one's like, okay, this is not cool. No. If you see the volunteers, you can see them smiling, having fun, always, always have fun, and always trying to make something else to have the stuff for missions, for the kids, always look for the good for everyone.